We leave the city at first light, which is just as well, for a terrible disease has spread across it. Dead and dying line the paths and choke the streams. Many are saying it is punishment from the gods. Journal of Adelantado Perez. November 24th, 1603. I accompanied Andreas Lopez, a group of 12 soldiers and 2 molossers through the jungle. The directions the Jesuits provided to Trinity were excellent, so we discovered the hidden city with little difficulty. The natives of the city welcomed us warily, but we plied them with gifts, and they reluctantly allowed us to enter the city, unaware of our true intentions. Lopez has begun to search for the artifact while we distract the city's leaders. That must be the temple I saw from the riverbanks. Hunvats and Hunchoen were twin brothers, older half-siblings of the more celebrated Maya hero twins. Jealous of their brothers, the monkey twins would always cheat during football matches and ruin them with their aggressive tactics. In retaliation, the hero twins lured them up a tree which never stopped growing, preventing Hunvats and Hunchoen from getting down. The hero twins convinced them that they could use their belts to climb down, but this turned out to be another trick, and the belts became tails, turning the elder twins into monkeys. Turn mirror 1 to the left. Follow the beam of light to mirror 2. Direct mirror 2 across the chamber diagonally. Return to mirror 1. These seem to be instructions of some kind, but I can't make out the rest. I must have arrived at the right time. It looks like the cultists were just here. Thank you. Only the worthy may call upon K'nichihal. Use his light to chase the shadows from your hearts and the city itself. Amazing. This must be where they perform rituals honoring the sun. Four mirrors, each with a different marking. They're numbered. This is mirror one. I'll need to go through the central pavilion to reach the altar. I'll have to find a way to lower that central pavilion. I won't last long if I fall in the water. This is mirror two. Need to create a path to mirror three. Need to create a path to mirror three. The divine canoe, which carries Maya's souls through the underworld and into the sky, is directed by two gods. Old Stingray Paddler sits in the back of the canoe and handles the duties during the day, while old Jaguar Paddler sits in the front and takes care of the night shift. These two gods symbolize not only light and darkness, day and night, but also the interdependence of all equal and opposite forces. Need to create a path to mirror three. Mirror 3. Need to create a path to Mirror 2. This must be Mirror 4. Need to create a path to Mirror 2. Shark was a very important god to the Maya. He taught them farming secrets and oversaw growing and the harvest. Generally, he was associated with all forms of fertility. He was also in charge of wind, lightning, and rain, which was caused by his tears. He was in charge of preserving springs, wells, streams, cenotes, and other sources of water. Like the aspects over which he presided, he was considered benevolent and caring, but unpredictable. Physically, Shark was depicted as a reptile with hair tangled in unruly knots, and his colors were white, red, yellow, and black, representing north, east, south, and west. To find a way out of here.
Huye, huye.
Yani, mati çekti değil başka.
This garishly decorated fire drill appears to be a part of the new fire ceremony, an Aztec celebration of the new year. It consists of 5 days of fasting, bloodletting, and sacrifice. The fire drill is meant to be placed upon the chest of the freshly sacrificed. It sparks, feeding a large bonfire that ignites the flames of every nearby temple. This one, however, doesn't appear to have been used, as the notches are clear of blood.
Come, Ishiki, I have supply.
Hello there.
What do you need? I am certain you will find it useful. You have made an excellent choice, my friend. I am certain you will find it useful. The gods favor us both. You have made an excellent choice, my friend. May the gods smile upon you.
Hatch Hoshok.
This describes something nearby. The waters below protect me from the waters above. I don't have enough space for that.
Ishik, başla.
Hmph!
Come see what I have to trade. What are you looking for?
Everything is for sale. Except Remax's drum. Good luck, Lara.
Jonah, I think I'm close to the mine entrance.
Uchu says it's at the edge of the mountain. He sent a rebel ahead to open it.
Thanks. These ceremonial ceramic jars are used to store corn beer or chicha. The bottom of these apu are usually pointed to aid when pouring into smaller serving containers. This describes something nearby. The youngest of four turns his back on his brothers, unable to speak as I lie in his mouth. Oh my god, this is a penguin lawn ornament, painted and decorated and placed in a location of reverence. I shouldn't laugh, but it's so incongruous. The locals wouldn't be able to identify the animal it's intended to represent, and they certainly wouldn't be familiar with the material the statue is made from. There isn't any plastic in Paititi. I'd love to talk to whoever did this and learn why, what they think this penguin is. Come to Lara. Here it is.
Kawujik Uhelani? Tulakas to Wushan. Telumo, Teiko. Taktehao Kawujik Bay. Danukimi Junkin, Mushanta, Yanusata, Yokul Kam. Masahaki,
I'm in.
Unuratu just left with Hakan. She'll be ready when you open the gate.